Alright, get your pen and paper right now, because if you ever have a sudden flash of inspiration, Apple's Notes app is definitely the place to jot it down. In this video, I'm going to show you 10 incredibly useful hidden Apple Notes features so you'll never lose a thought again. This first feature is mind-blowing. A note is not only limited to lifeless text, no, you can also save and listen to audio recordings directly in the Notes app, a feature that's especially helpful for students who want to record their lectures. So here's how to do it. Create a new recording in any app. Let's just use the pre-installed Voice Memos app on your iPhone. When done, tap on the three dots to open this pop-up menu here. Tap on Share and scroll along in the list of apps until you find Notes. You can either create a new note including your audio or add it to an existing one. Tap Save, and when back in the Notes app, you can play the recording directly from there. Again, you can do this using most audio files, even with WhatsApp voice messages. Whatever it is, just tap Share and choose the Notes app. So we've learned how to integrate audio recordings into our notes. But this also works with videos. Save them to your notes and watch them directly inside the app. Either choose a video saved to your camera roll by tapping on the camera icon above the keyboard and selecting Choose Photo or Video. Select your video and tap Add. Tapping on the play button will instantly open a video player. But wait, it gets even more exciting. If you come across a helpful online video, let's say on YouTube, you can also save that to your note for later reference. Tap on Share and choose Notes in the list of apps. Share to an existing note or create a new one. Back in the Notes app, you'll find a mini player with the YouTube video and you can watch it without having to leave the app. Crazy, right? Alright, we talked about audio and video, but it's just getting better and better and better. Want to save a PDF to your note? No problem. Browse a PDF saved to your Files app or anywhere on your iPhone. Tap and hold the PDF, choose Share, and again select Notes from the list of apps. Add the document to an existing note or create a new one. Back in the Notes app, your note will now display the first page of your PDF. If you tap on it, the document will open and you can edit and use it like any other PDF file. You can also create new PDFs from physical paper by scanning documents right from your Notes app using your iPhone's camera. Tap on the camera icon and select Scan Documents. Hold your iPhone above any sheet of paper and the camera will accurately detect the edges. You can now tap Save and it's pasted into the Notes app as a PDF document. So this right here is the default view of your notes, a long, boring list. If that's too chaotic for you, you're not stuck with this view. Go to any folder and tap the three dots in the top right corner. Here, select View as Gallery. You'll now see a preview image for every note, which is especially helpful if you're working with lots of visuals like images or drawings. Tap and hold on any note and it will open as a preview. Just a quick break. If I'm missing out on any features you love using in Apple Notes, please share them with the community down below in the comments. Alright, next one. You don't have to be lonely in Apple Notes. You can easily work together with another iPhone, iPad, or Mac user. Go to a note you want to collaborate on, tap the Share icon, and choose Collaborate at the top of the pop-up menu. You can also select Send a copy, but then you'll just send a duplicate of the note and the other person won't see any new edits. Tap the text below and you've got a couple more options. Choose that anyone who receives your link can edit the note or restrict it only to your chosen contacts. You can also change the permission to View Only, which means nobody except you can make any changes. And lastly, you can forbid others to invite more people to the note using the toggle down here. Hit Done and choose a messaging app to share the note. You can now open the note in your shared folder and see other people making edits in real time. By default, your notes will be sorted by date edited. However, you can change the sorting method to your liking. Again, go to any folder and tap on the three dots in the top right corner. Select Sort By and choose your favorite sorting method, either date edited, date created, or in alphabetical order. Regardless of the sorting method you choose, if you ever want to have easy access to a note, you can pin it to the top so it stays there. Swipe right on a note and choose the pin icon or tap and hold and select pin note. It's now moved to the top of your folder. You can pin as many notes as you want. You probably knew already that you could sort notes manually into folders. But there's another, faster method to categorize your notes. If you often create notes about the same topic, type a hashtag anywhere in your text. Let's use hashtag subscribe, and the app will automatically create a tag. You can view your tags if you go to the folders window, there right at the bottom. Tap on a tag to find all notes using it. You can also sort the tagged notes automatically into smart folders. Tap on the folder icon in the bottom left corner. Name it and select Make into Smart Folder. Choose Tags, tap on any selected tags, and type in the tag you want to use. Again, we're going to use Subscribe. Tap Done, and all notes with the tag you chose will be sorted into your folder. This also works for notes you'll create in the future. Speaking of folders, many Notes users wonder if you can create subfolders, like in any file browser. And yes, you can. Just tap and hold a folder and drag and drop it into another one. Next to your parent folder, you now find an arrow indicating that it has more subfolders to it. Tap on the arrow to view the subfolders and tap again to hide them. A very basic but helpful feature. If you created a note which belongs to your eyes only, you can restrict access to it. First, activate the feature in the Settings app. Scroll down to Notes and tap on Password. You can now choose to use your device passcode and face or touch ID to lock your notes, or you can create a custom password only for the Notes app. I want it to be easy, so I'm going to leave it on Face ID. When in your secret note, tap on the three dots in the top right corner and select Lock Note. Your note can now only be accessed using Face or Touch ID or your passcode. For sudden flashes of inspiration, you can quickly create a new note from your Control Center. First, add the feature in the Settings app. Go to Control Center and add Notes. Once added, tap the icon once to create a new note. For more options, tap and hold the icon and you can create a new note, new checklist, new photo, or scan a document. Another option is to add Quick Note to your Control Center, which when tapped will open up a pop-up note to quickly jot something down. Your Quick Notes are then automatically saved to a Quick Note folder, so you can categorize them when you have time. Bonus tip, you can also create notes hands-free. Tell Siri to create a new note and she will ask you what you want to write down. You'll never forget your ideas again. I mean, note-taking is only one of the thousands of things Siri is capable of, and there might still be lots of commands you're missing out on. I can help you out if you watch this video next. I guarantee it will make your life much easier and more comfortable. I'll see you there. Thanks so much for watching and have a good day.